बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। टुडे वी विल स्टडी ऑइंटमेंट इन द सेक्शन ऑफ इन द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ डोजेज फ्रॉम साइंस। फॉर टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज ऑइंटमेंट्स। एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अर्लियर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ डोजेज फॉर्म लाइक जेल्स, सस्पेंशंस। टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज ऑइंटमेंट एंड एज वी नो दैट ऑइंटमेंट इज अ टॉपिकल प्रिपरेशन। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल हैव टू मेक अ क्लियर डिफरेंस बिटवीन द टॉपिकल प्रिपरेशन एंड ट्रांसडर्मल ड्रग डिलीवरी सिस्टम। टॉपिकल प्रिपरेशन एज द नेम इज सेल्फ एक्सप्लेनेटरी दैट दीज प्रिपरेशन आर यूज आइदर फॉर लोकल और सिस्टेमिक इफेक्ट। A topical dermatological product is designed to deliver drug into the skin in treating dermal disorders with skin as a target organ. Transdermal drug delivery system. This system is designed to deliver drug through the skin to general circulation for systemic effect, with the skin not being the target organ. So, dear students, as we can see that there is a clear distinction between the topical dermatological product and transdermal drug delivery system. In topical preparation, our target organ is skin, that we want our pharmacological effect on the skin, that is local effect. We can say that it will produce a local effect where you apply the ointment, the effect will be produced on the same site. But as far as transdermal drug delivery system is concerned, this system is used to produce effect on the systemic level, means there will be percutaneous absorption through the skin. The active moiety or the API of your product from the ointment will pass through the layers of the skin and will absorb in the blood and then will produce the systemic effect. So let's proceed further. As far as the definition of the ointment is concerned, these are semi-solid preparations intended for external application to the skin or mucous membrane. Ointments may also be placed on the surface of the eye or may be used nasally, rectally, or vaginally. Ointments may be medicated or non-medicated. Non-medicated ointments are used for physical effect as emollient, lubricant, or as a vehicle for API. Emollient means to produce soothing or softening effect on the skin. Lubricant means to protect the dehydration of water from your skin. Hope that all the concepts will be clear now. Let's repeat it. Topical preparation is a broad term. If we use a topical dermatological preparation, then we mean that we want our desired pharmacological effect on the surface of the skin, local effect. We want to produce local effect. While transdermal drug delivery system, as we have discussed, we need the percutaneous absorption in this type of dosage form. There are basically two types of ointments as far as types of ointments are concerned. Number one is water insoluble ointments. Number two, water soluble ointments. Further, water soluble ointments are of two types, emulsifying ointments and non-emulsifying ointments. Emulsifying ointment means that it will produce emulsification, and non-emulsifying means it will not produce emulsification. As you have We have gone through the term what emulsification is. Classification of ointments. We classify ointments broadly on two bases. That is on the basis of penetration through the skin and on the basis of therapeutic use. First, we will discuss classification of ointments on the basis of penetration. By penetration, we means that throughout your skin, where from which level up to which level your ointment will penetrate, the active pharmaceutical ingredient will penetrate from your ointment. On the basis of penetration, ointments are of the following types. Number one, epidermic ointments. By epidermic ointments, we mean that they are used on the epidermis of the skin and are meant for local effect and not absorbed within the skin. They are mainly used as a protective, antiseptic, and local anti-infective. These are the terms which require further clarification protective means we want to protect our skin from dehydration, antiseptic to kill the germs on the surface of the skin, and local anti-infective against any microorganisms. Second type is endodermic ointment. These ointments are meant for action on the deeper layer of the skin, and here partial absorption occurs in the layers of the skin and mainly used as an emollient, stimulant and local irritant. Number third type is diadermic ointments. These ointments are meant for the deeper penetration and release the medicament. By medicament we mean our active ingredient that pass through the skin and produce systemic effect. Classification on the basis of therapeutic use, we can classify ointments in different categories as per the active ingredients. Mainly the broad categories are: number one, antibiotic ointments. These ointments are used to kill microorganisms, and the agent which is used in these ointments as active pharmaceutical ingredients are antibiotics. The common examples are neomycin and bacitracin. These are the ointments which are used to kill microorganisms. Antifungal ointments. As the name is self-explanatory, these ointments are used to kill or inhibit the growth or kill fungi. Examples are benzoic acid, nystatin, salicylic acid, etc. Number third is anti-inflammatory ointments. Anti-inflammatory ointments means which inhibit the inflammation. These ointments are used for inflammation, allergy, and pruritic condition of the skin. Agents used are betamethasone, valerate, and hydrocortisone and its acetate. Anti-pruritic ointment. These ointments are used to relieve the itching of the skin. Agents used are benzoic acid and charcoal. Anti-pruritic means those agents which are used against the itching which are produced on the skin. Next category in the classification of ointments on the basis of therapeutic use is astringent ointments. These ointments are used for the contraction of the skin to inhibit the discharge from the skin. Agents used are calamine, zinc oxide, and tannic acid, etc. So, dear students, up till now we have discussed that what is topical preparation, what is transdermal drug delivery system, what are the types of ointments, and what is the classification of ointments. As far as classification is concerned, as we have discussed, we have classified ointments on the basis of its penetration in the skin and on the basis of the therapeutic use. So let's proceed further. Now, the most important thing in the ointment preparation or formulation is the ointment base. There are different things in the formulation we use in the formulation of different types of dosage form. Like we require preservative, we require along with preservative, we require antioxidants, we require chelating agents. So there are different types of requirements for different formulation. As far as ointments are concerned, the major thing that we use in the preparation of ointment is the ointment base. So let's discuss the ointment bases. First, we will discuss that what is ointment base. Actually, it is the carrier or vehicle for the API in the ointment. As the base means it will be in greater quantity in the preparation, and we will dissolve, suspend, or solubilize our active ingredient in these ointment bases. So according to USP, as you know, that stands for United States Pharmacopoeia, ointment bases are generally classified into four groups or categories: oleaginous bases, absorption bases, water removable bases, and number four is water soluble bases. So let's take one by one. Oleaginous bases. Oleaginous, as the name indicates, these are oily bases. They are also called hydrocarbon bases, and these are semi-solid water insoluble bases that are obtained from petroleum. Examples are petroleum or soft paraffin, and soft paraffin are of two types, that is white soft paraffin and yellow soft paraffin. White soft paraffin are not used in ophthalmic preparations because during bleaching, by bleaching we means that we are going to convert or change the color of yellow paraffin into white paraffin. So for that purpose we use bleaching agent which can decolorize it. So when we decolorize our white soft paraffin, then traces of bleaching agents may remain in the white soft paraffin, and when you formulate it for ophthalmic preparation, then it will cause irritation of the eyes. These bases are immiscible with water and therefore not easy to wash. If when you will apply it on your skin, then it will be difficult to remove it because the base is oily. They are used for emollient effect, protect the escaping of moisture, and use as occlusive dressings, can remain on the skin for long period of time without drying. Therefore, these types of ointments are used for emollient effect, means to produce softening and cooling effect on the skin, and are applied in occlusive dressings so that we want the ingredients to remain on the surface of the skin. Therefore, we use these types of ointment in occlusive dressings. The second base is absorption base. Absorption bases are, these are the hydrophilic mixtures of the hydrocarbons and anhydrous in nature, and they do not contain water in their basic formula. What does it mean? It means that absorption, that means that it is after all hydrophilic mixture of the hydrocarbons, means it is oily in nature but it has no water in its basic formula or in its basic structure. Therefore, they have the property to absorb sufficient quantity of water from water in oil and form water in oil emulsion and retain its consistency. This is the ability of the absorption base, that it has either it is hydrophilic in nature with containing lot of hydrocarbons which are oily in nature. Instead of this type of bases have the ability to dissolve sufficient quantity of water without changing its consistency. There are two types of emulsion absorption bases. Number one, non-emulsified bases. They absorb water and form water in oil emulsion. As we have discussed our dosage form emulsions and its types, so hope that the concept will be clear. Examples are wool fat, wool alcohol, beeswax, etc. These are the examples of non-emulsified bases, means emulsification will not take place. Water in oil emulsion bases, hydrous wool fat, which is called lanolin, is the example of water in oil emulsion basis. As you can see that water in oil means oil is the continuous phase and water is the dispersed phase. Even then, if you will add further water in it, the consistency of the base will remain same. Absorption bases are used as an emollient, although they do not provide the degree of occlusion as that by oleaginous bases. They do not easily remove from the skin because the external phase is oily. Got it? Number third base, water removable bases. As the name is self-explanatory, these are oil in water emulsions. Means water is the continuous phase, resembling creams. Oil in water emulsions are also called creams. The external phase is water, therefore easily removed from the skin. They may be diluted with water or aqueous solution. Hydrophilic ointment USP is the example of this type of base. Water removable base means that if we will apply it on our skin, it will easily be removed because the continuous phase is water. The fourth type of base, ointment base, is water soluble bases. Water soluble bases means these bases do not contain oleaginous component. They are completely water washable and often referred as greaseless. Greaseless because there is no oil in the base, because they soften greatly with the addition of water. These bases are mostly used for the incorporation of solid substances. Examples are polyethylene glycol is the example. As far as the ointment bases are concerned, we have discussed that there are four types of ointment bases as per USP. Number one is oleaginous bases. Number two is absorption bases. Number three, water removable bases. And number four, water soluble bases. You will have to memorize the examples of each base. Now, the important thing is the selection of ointment base, that on which basis we will select our ointment base. So, following are the main considerations that you will have to consider while selecting your ointment base for your formulation. Following factors, but are not limited to, need to be considered while selecting an ointment base. Number one, requirements as either topical or percutaneous absorption is required. It means that for which purpose you are formulating your ointment, either you want local effect or you want percutaneous absorption, means absorption through skin, and then the API will enter in your blood and will produce the desired pharmacological response. Second thing is the stability of the drug or your API in the ointment base. We will have to consider it that the active ingredient of our formulation must not interact with the base of the ointment. If there will be an interaction, then it will affect our bioavailability. Number third is desire for the base that is easily removable with water. This is one of the requirements that formulators want to, for the elegant effect or elegantly pharmaceutical product, the ointment must be removable with water. Number four is the characteristics of the surface to which it is applied. What are the characteristics or what are the features of that surface for which you are preparing your ointment? Now let's proceed further, that what are the characteristics of ideal ointments. There are few properties that must be present in an ointment formulation. Number one is non-sensitizing, means it will not produce any sensation, non-irritating, pharmaceutically elegant so that you can handle it easily, efficient release of the drug at the site of application, non-dehydrating, water washable, and non-greasy. These are the characteristics of ideal ointment. Let's proceed further. Now, we will discuss what are the methods of preparation of ointments. So, as far as your course is concerned, there are three types of methods which can be used for the preparation of ointment. Number one, trituration method. Trituration method is the consists of the on the following steps. Step number one, first we will finely powder the solid material, the material which we want to formulate in our ointment or we want to incorporate it in our ointment. We will have to convert it into a fine powdered form. Second step, we will weigh the required quantity of ointment base. Ointment base we will use in two steps. First step, we will triturate our powdered product with the ointment, and in the last step, then we will add the remaining quantity of the base until the medicament is uniformly mixed and it will produce a semi-solid preparation. Second method is emulsification. Emulsification method, there are following steps in this method required. First of all, we will weigh or take our required quantity of the ingredients. Then what will we do? The fat, oil and waxes are melted together on water bath at 70 degrees centigrade. Means all the oily components are melted together on water bath at 70 degrees centigrade. Then we will prepare a second solution of all those heat stable components in a separate beaker or a separate container and will heat it up to the same temperature. Like we have heated our oily substances on water bath at 70 degrees centigrade. So we will have to heat our aqueous solutions. By aqueous solution, we means that all those substances that are soluble in water. So we do, we will separately solubilize it in water, and then we will heat it up to 70 degrees centigrade. Now, what will we do in the fourth step? The aqueous solution is slowly added to the melted base with continuous stirring until cool down and semi-solid mass is formed, which is known as ointment. So emulsification method is easy method, and we will apply it also in our lab. That first we will melt all the oily components of our formulation, then we will melt or heat all the aqueous soluble substances in aqueous phase, then we will add aqueous phase in oily phase, and will stir continuously until a semi-solid mass is formed, which is known as ointment. The third method is fusion method. When the ointment contains a number of solid ingredients with different melting points, it is necessary to melt them in decreasing order of their melting points. After melting, the medicament is slowly added to the melted mass and stir until the mass is cooled down and give a homogeneous product. So dear students, as we have discussed, there are three methods for the preparation of ointments. Number one is trituration, number two is emulsification method, and number three is fusion method. Now let's proceed further. Last thing, packaging, storage, and labeling. Actually, ointments are required special consideration during storage, so we will discuss it. In large mouth, ointments are usually packed in large mouth ointment jars or in metal or plastic tubes. In well-closed containers to protect against contamination, and in cool place to protect against product separation due to heat. Because as you know that we have combined two phases in ointment, so there are chances that heat will separate the phases of the ointment. When required, light sensitive preparations are packed in light resistant containers, or you can say that in amber glass containers. Light sensitive products are usually packed in amber glass containers. In addition to the usual labeling requirements for pharmaceutical products, the USP directs that the labeling for certain ointments and creams include the type of base used, like water soluble, insoluble, and there must be a clear distinction on the label that the product is for external use only. So dear students, up till now, it was the lecture on the ointment bases. Let's take a quick revision of the lectures from slide number one. In the first slide, we had discussed that what are topical preparation. Topical preparation can produce both systemic and local effect. And if we put a name like a topical dermatological product, then it means that it is designed to deliver drug into the skin in treating dermal disorders with the skin as a target organ. Means you required your action on the surface of the skin, on or within the skin. But the active pharmaceutical ingredients will not cross all the barriers of the skin and will absorb in the systemic circulation. So this is a distinction for a topical dermatological product. Now, transdermal drug delivery system. In this system, we require our active ingredient to pass through all the barriers of the skin and absorb in the systemic circulation for its effect. Now let's discuss shortly that these are semi-solid preparation intended for external application, in which the active pharmaceutical ingredient is suspended or solubilized in ointment base. Ointments may be medicated or non-medicated. Non-medicated ointments are usually used for physical effects like emollient protection, etc. Types of ointment: water soluble, insoluble. Then we have discussed classification on the basis of penetration and on the basis of therapeutic use. On the basis of penetration, epidermis, if the effect is localized to the epidermis of your skin, means there will be no absorption. Endodermis means deeper layers of the skin, and diadermic, that it means penetration across the layers of the skin, and the medicament will pass through the skin and produce systemic effect. Therapeutic classification of ointments are antibiotic ointments like neomycin, bacitracin, antifungal like benzoic acid, nestatin, salicylic acid, etc., anti-inflammatory ointments, hydrocortisone, betamethasone, or corticosteroids are usually employed. Antipruritic ointment means those ointments which are used against itching of the skin, and the active ingredients are benzoic acid and charcoal. Astringent ointments are used for the contraction or to the skin to inhibit the discharge from the skin. Agents used as calamine, zinc oxide, and tannic acids. Types of ointment base. Ointment base are actually the carrier of your API. Oleaginous base means containing hydrocarbons, oily in nature, not easily washable. Absorption bases, hydrophilic mixture of hydrocarbon, have the ability to absorb sufficient quantity of water and without changing its consistency, and can produce non-emulsified bases or water in oil emulsions. Water removable bases. These are oil in water emulsions. Oil in water means water is continuous phase, so they can easily be removed with the water. Water soluble bases, they are soluble in water, non-greasy in nature. Example is polyethylene glycol. Selection of ointment bases, as we have discussed, you will have to consider following points. Characteristics of ideal ointments, that it will be non-sensitizing, non-irritating, pharmaceutically elegant, efficient release of your active pharmaceutical ingredient, non-dehydrating, water washable, and non-greasy. Methods of preparation of ointments: trituration method, emulsification method, and fusion method. Storage and labeling: ointment jars, metal, plastic tubes are used with screw caps. Ointments usually contain screw caps. In well-closed container to protect against contamination, must be stored in cool and dry place to avoid product separation or phase separation. When light sensitive product is packed in oil, it must be packed in amber colored or light resistant containers. In addition to the usual labeling requirements as described by the regulatory authorities, the ointment for labeling also include the type of base used in the formulation of ointment, and there must be a clear distinctions that ointments are used for topical preparation. Dear students, we will upload next lecture, as our next topic will be creams, lotions. So we will discuss the dosage form. Thank you very much.